Hey folks, did you have a good holiday? Was your New Year's a lot of fun? Safe, but fun? I hope so. So anyway, a few weeks ago, when I finished decorating my Christmas tree, I did a video about it, and I promised that I would count how many ornaments were on my tree when I took it down. Because there's a lot. There's a whole lot on the tree. It takes a really long time for me to do this. And I did. I did count them, and before this video ends, I will reveal what the final count was. But I also mentioned in that video that because I got a slightly larger tree than usual, I was frustrated because I had bare spots. I had to leave parts of the back side of the tree undecorated because I didn't have enough ornaments. And I said that I would have to make some more. Well, I did that too. It's become a bit of a tradition that one day every year during my number one granddaughter's Christmas break from school, she'll come over and we'll make ornaments for her to take back home for her mom to put on their tree. So we did that. Now every year we do something different, and I have to always make sure it's something that a young child can do, at least with some supervision. And it's a little bit of a challenge each year to come up with something, but this year we did beaded snowflakes. I decided to do that. There are places online where you can buy the little wire frames to make a beaded snowflake, but I didn't have time to order them and receive them before we were ready to do them. So I learned a new skill. I learned how to solder. Paul Neverblatz taught me how to do it and made me a little jig to hold three pieces of wire simultaneously while I apply the solder in the center to hold them and create the six arms of the snowflake. So that was a lot of fun. To give you an idea of what it is we made, I'll show you some of them. So there are simple ones like these. Okay. Those are the kind mostly that my granddaughter and I made. Then a little more complicated ones. I started having fun and playing like those. Or really complicated ones, like this guy. So, let's see, there we go. I had a lot of fun doing these, and I actually found they were pretty well received. I made them as gifts for people as well, and everybody who got them liked them. So I thought, you know, I wonder if I could actually make more and sell them. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a whole bunch of beaded things, not just snowflakes. A whole bunch of other things, I won't tell you right now what all they are, and create a little store on Etsy. I don't know if you're familiar with Etsy. In case any of you guys are interested, when the time comes, I'll give you a link, but it's mostly going to be a lot of fun and another revenue source, which we all know that's desperately needed. Anyway, so that's what we did, and I made a bunch to go on my own tree. And, well, in truth, it still wasn't enough. Honestly, in my opinion, my tree could still use more ornaments, so I'll have to keep working on that. Anyway, back to how many ornaments were on the tree. Because I have a lot of different ornaments, and I'm a little bit psycho as far as organizing things go. I know you can't tell if I'm looking at my office because my office is always a mess, but certain things I'm very, very psycho about. And so when I take down the ornaments off the tree, they all get segregated as to what type of ornament they are and get packaged, so to speak. There are a few things that go into boxes because they're more delicate. Other things go into Ziploc bags. Well, I had them all, as I take them down off the tree, I lay them out in various piles, you know, sorting them as I go. And once I was all done, I had Neverblatz take a guess as to how many ornaments there were. Okay, now remember, this is a 7-foot tree, and it had a pretty decent girth to it. His guess was 200 to 300 ornaments. Well, I didn't tell him at the time, but in the back of my mind, I was picturing more like somewhere closer to 1,000. I know it's ridiculous, right? But remember, there's a lot of little tiny, tiny ornaments on my tree. I mean, little berries and these little pieces made from deconstructed jewelry. I mean, there's a lot of little things, so cut me some slack. Anyway, I did count them. And drum roll, please. The grand total of ornaments on the tree this year was 751. So I guess I win. I was closer than Neverblatz was. I don't know if you guys decided to try and guess yourselves, but there you go. Now you know. And next year there'll be more. I'll have to keep getting bigger trees, I guess. Anyway, at the end of this video, in case you're curious, I'm going to scroll a list of what all it was just by groups and how many were in the groups. slow it down and count them, and you can see for yourself it really does equal 751. Anyway, that's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya!